This cost me about $12, believe it or not. Now, that's $12 Canadian. That could be cheaper somewhere else, but that's what I paid. And I'm going to go over some of this candy for you and tell you about it. But before I go any further, a shout out to Caden Hiller. I meant to do a shout out to Caden Hiller a long time ago. Somehow there was a lapse somewhere and I missed that. So my apologies to Caden Hiller. So a big shout out to you, my friend. And a big shout out to the rest of you as well. Okay, so anyways, when I was a kid, candy was a lot cheaper. For instance, this here chocolate bar or candy bar was 10 cents. That's what we called a 10 cent chocolate bar. And they were actually packaged differently too. Not only were they bigger and cheaper, but the packaging was tighter, almost like skin tight. Now they package it a lot looser, you know, like that. So it looks like it's not that much smaller, but it has shrunk a bit. Even the Mars bars have shrunk a little bit. Not that much, though. Now, this is the only thing I didn't buy. I found this in my dresser drawer. It's been there for years. I can't remember where it came from, but it's been there for a long time. Already a long time. So, I'm gonna try this, see what it's like. I was never big on lollipops. I like jawbreakers, but lollipops, I always found that they got kind of soggy around there and they started to kind of fall over. You can see that one's a bit old, you know. I said this thing was in my drawer for years. I mean, it's been there so long I can't remember where I got it or how long it's been there, but I'm sure it's been there for not only years but decades. When I bought that, I probably paid 2 cents for it. So, got some chips. These things here. These used to be candy cigarettes. These Popeye. They used to be candy cigarettes. Now they just call them candy sticks. And they used to be bigger. The package was bigger. And I think you got about 20 or 25 in a package. And now I certainly don't condone smoking by any stretch. When I was a kid and she bought one of these, I paid 50 cents for this. One end would have a little red thing on the end of it, so it looked like a lit cigarette. Just tastes like sugar. Now I'm totally on board young people with cigarette smoking, because they shouldn't be doing that. And I remember when I was a kid, we used to get these bubblegum cigarettes. Get, yeah, you know, yellow, purple, blue, pink, and they're actually wrapped. They look like a cigarette, and they had I guess it was cornstarch or icing sugar between the paper and the gum. So you'd blow it, go, and the very first puff, you blow out all this cornstarch. So it kind of looked like a cigarette. It was kind of funny, but it was really good bubble gum. So that's kind of interesting. Now, when I was a kid in Saskatoon, I had my favorite candy store. And it was only a few blocks. Now, if you took the long way, which is going down the streets and down that street and that street, it was probably about 3 or 4 blocks. It would take you 15 or 20 minutes to get there. But Saskatoon, every street, every neighborhood has back alleys. You know, the garbage trucks go down there, that sort of thing. More like access roads, so they all had back alleys. down straight down the alley. You're at the store in no time. And one time my friend Rich and I were playing in his backyard. And his auntie came out and she gave us each a dime, 10 cents. And we thought, well, you know, she was going to give us heck for playing in the corn. But she came, she was so happy that we were being such good kids that she gave us each a dime to go to the store. And it was kind of funny because she was babysitting us because Richard's mom was working. And Richard's mom, she was Welsh. She wasn't born in Wales. She was actually born in China because she, her father was a naval man. And, you know, she just happened to be along at that time with her dad and her mom, and she was born in China, so. But she was actually Welsh, and she always referred to Wales and Europe as the old country. She'd always say, well, you know, Auntie Vera's come to visit from the old country, or this kind of thing, so. Anyways, Rich's Aunt Vera was babysitting us that day, and she was so happy that we were being such good kids, she gave us each 10 cents to go down the store. Back then, 10 cents would buy you a lot of candies. They had these little things called Mojos, and they were like a little spearmint taffy thing. They were made about a little bit smaller than that caramel, more of a rectangle shape. And they were 3 for 1. They were about the cheapest candies. They were 3 for 1. And, they were a good deal. For 10 cents, you could get a bag of candies, man, you know. It was unbelievable. Like I said, I paid like 12 bucks for all of this. You know, $12 is a lot of money for just this stuff. Back in when I was a kid, it would have been a lot cheaper than this. Everything has shrunk over the years. Even the caramels have gotten smaller. This is bubblegum. It's wrapped in cellophane before they put it in the bag, which is probably a more food safe thing, because when I was a kid they never had the cellophane, so moisture could have got in there and whatever, but even that's gotten smaller, you know. But that's just the way it is. This is pretty busy. those are. That's really, really old tasting. It's got kind of a funky old taste to it. Wow. Better drink some water. Yikes. I used to buy Beatle cards when I was a kid. 5 cents per pack of Beatle cards. You get 5 cards and a stick of bubblegum for 5 cents. So for 25 cents, you could get 25 cards and 5 pieces of bubblegum. And I just loved opening up that brand new pack of Beatle cards. And you could smell the bubblegum. You know, it was just amazing. I just loved it. Wow. A bottle of pop when I was a kid like this was 14 cents. 12 cents if you drank it in the store. Because that way, if you've drank it in the store, you left the bottle behind and you didn't have to pay the 2 cent deposit on it. But if you took it out of the store, it was 14 cents. Yeah, I'll tell you, when I was a kid, things were a lot cheaper. But I guess it was all relative. Yeah, let me see. Let's see if I go back to when I was 8 years old. That would have been about 1965, so 1965, oh man, things were cheap back then. If only it were 1965 again. Wow, I'd love to go back to 1965, go down the candy store. You know, that candy store. Like I say, if you run right down the alley, there it was. There was this, like, there's about 5 or 6 stores in this block, you know, this one building. There's a bakery at the back, a drugstore at the front, the candy store, which is called Peterson's Confectionery, barbershop, a beauty salon, and a grocery store. I think I got my hair cut at the barbershop once. The drugstore was kind of cool. They had Tinker Toys and Halloween masks at Halloween and stuff like that. The bakery is really good. Oh man, I used to go there a lot and buy Balmorals and stuff. And we used to pick up our newspapers there. When we delivered, we just kind of hang around the bakery. But my favorite store was Peterson's Confectionery. Oh, that place was heaven on earth. The Petersons were a lovely family. The old man and his adult kids worked there. They were just wonderful. They always gave back to the community. You know, they supported softball teams. I mean, they sold loaves of bread and cans of soup and stuff and milk, but most of their money came from candy and cigarettes. But the candy back then was just amazing. Oh, that was my favorite store. Oh, it'd be so amazing to go back to 1965. That'd be wonderful to go back to 1965.
Hi. Thanks for coming over to my house to play with me. As you can see, I got a lot of candy today. I broke into my piggy bank, and I got 80 cents out of it, and I was able to buy all this stuff. I got some of these cherry twists. These are a penny each. I wanted to get some of those marshmallow strawberries. Those are 2 for 1, but they're all sold out. These are only, 2 for a penny. I like these caramels. this in my dresser drawer. I just leave it there till some other time. Maybe in a few years I'll enjoy that. I got a crispy crunch. 10 cents. A 5 cent bag of chips. They all have 10 cent bags of chips, but I didn't get a 10 cent bag. And I just got the 10 cent chocolate bars. I didn't get any 25 cent chocolate bars. But the last time I bought them, they were a lot bigger. This marshmallow thing was 5 cents. I bought all of this for 80 cents. And that bottle I bought for 14. 14 cents for that. And I can take that bottle back to the store and get a 2 cent deposit. I can buy 6 mojos. They didn't have any mojos today. I was quite disappointed. A cherry flavor. Never had one before. That was only 5 cents when I bought it. marshmallow and chocolate's a good combination. Sometimes I'll take 6 pop bottles down the store. I'll get 12 cents for it. And I can buy a whole bunch of candy with that. Mustache. I know it looks real, but it's not. It's the stick-on kind. Makes me look older, doesn't it? One time our neighbors had a tree, and it had a whole bunch of tin caterpillars in it. You know those orange and black caterpillars? I stuck one on my lip, and it looked just like a mustache. Barbecue's my favorite kind. The only other kinds they have is plain, onion, garlic, ripple, and salt and vinegar. This was 10 cents. There's a lot of bubblegum in there. A lot of bubblegum. Smells good. Wow, look at all that bubblegum. Whenever I buy one of these, I always keep that little sack. It's handy to put pennies in and stuff like that. Sometimes I wish I had lots of money so I could spend it all at Peterson's Confectionery. They got so much stuff. I don't even know what the word confectionery means. $0.10. That's the best deal. Whenever I go swimming at the swimming pool, I always buy popcorn twists. Because you get lots and they last a long time. See if I can unwrap another caramel. I'll do my best. Every time I go to the candy store, the candy seems to get smaller. Last a long time. Pieces of little babies or something. Make sure I brush my teeth after this. Wow. I love chips. Those big long licorice twists. Those are only $0.02. Those are good. And shoestrings are about 3 feet long. They only cost a penny. I like popsicles. Popsicles do anything that are more than a nickel but less than 10 cents. They cost 7 cents. Fudgicles and Riffles are 10 cents. Drumsticks are 10 cents. I could buy a big bag of chips for 10 cents and a bottle of pop for a quarter with 25 cents to have a penny left over and get three mojos. If you wonder what that noise is, that's my dad hammering something. Be happy that I spent all my money on junk. But anyways, I'm glad you came over and had some of my candy. I don't mind sharing it. Well, thanks for coming over. And I hope you come over and visit me again sometime. That was weird, wasn't it? That was really weird. Was that weird? That was really strange. Like, wow. Man, that was bizarre. What a flashback. Wow. Wow. Tastes like cobwebs or something. It's really weird. You know, I'm not proud of this, but when I was a teenager, I did probably my fair share of street drugs. My friends always warn me one of these days to have some weird flashback where you go back to when you were a kid. I should have listened. Anyways, this thing's been hanging around a long time. Well, I don't know what else to say, but that was kind of a weird trip, wasn't it? I hope you enjoyed my candy video. Like I said, you know, things are a lot more expensive than they were when I was a kid, but, you know, when you're a kid, things are fun, you know. I had a lot of fun as a kid. I really did. And I enjoyed buying candy, you know. Like I said, this haul was about $12, believe it or not. It's hard to believe, but it was. Well, anyways, my friends, that's it. I hope you enjoyed this, and I hope that you're doing well. And I'm not sure what I'm going to do with all this. I'll probably have to give it to Linda's grandkids or something, because I can't imagine eating all this. Maybe if I was a kid, I could probably do it, but not at my age. Anyways, you take care, my friends. Thanks for tuning in. Stay awesome, and I'll talk to you again soon.